Hello again, groovy guys and gals. I'm Barry with Barry's A-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. And when I'm doing my videos, I kind of feel like an astronaut because I got my Bluetooth headset here. I got my headset mic going to this mouth here. This going to that ear. This going to this mouth. I got my cool little moon rocket controls to play with. I think I'm ready for Mars. I think. Wait a minute. Let me make myself even more ready for Mars. Nope. Wrong color. There, now I'm a Martian. Okay, enough of the playing around, guys. We got work to do here. This is a unit out of a 70 Oldsmobile. It's a Delco T400, and don't try to adjust your TV screen. There is no faceplate on this model. I do get quite a few units in without faceplates. Customer may have sent it off to a rechroming shop. It may have been freshly rechromed, and the customer didn't want me to scratch it, so he kept it. Who knows, but we don't need the faceplate to test the 8-track player and make sure it works properly. So on the, you might know by now that I like to label all the wires either on the paperwork, the envelope that the customer's paperwork comes in. We'll usually have a diagram of what the connector pins go to. This being an Oldsmobile unit and missing some of the connectors, this could be kind of difficult to install and troubleshoot if there's a problem. So I like to just go ahead and label all the wires so that there's no confusion as to which wire goes to what. This is our 12 volt wire, this goes to our ride speaker, etc. And this type of unit is designed to do the speaker switching as well. The speaker switching actually occurs inside the 8-track with the Delco system, and so we need to make sure that the 8-track is sending the speakers to the radio when there's no tape inserted, so we'll be testing that as well. Let's go ahead and hook this puppy up. It's not quite as scary as it might look. Let's see, we got our right speaker wire here. Alrighty. Just any old ground we can find, any old place is good right there. Okay, gonna hook up our left speaker. Alrighty, left speaker. That is this wire. Dark blue wire is our left speaker, so here we go. Hook that puppy up. And find a handy ground for this one too. This will probably work. Okay, now we just gotta connect power. And our power is right here. Looking for the 12 volt wire. There's our 12 volt wire. Okay, and find a handy ground for that one. I think this will work just fine. Okay, we should be ready to test this unit. Okay, first we're going to test to make sure it plays tapes properly. We've got, let's try some Temptations this time. Got some Temptations on deck. Everything turned on, ready to go. Here we go, folks. Switch tracks. I'm gonna take a look at our output level meters, make sure both speakers are working. Rotate our balance control all the way left, all the way right, left, right, center the speakers, work our tone control for that dull sound, turn it back up for that bright sound. Okay, gonna switch tracks some more. Between songs here and the end of a song there, so we're probably going to be looking at a track change, an automatic track change in the next few seconds since a lot of songs are ending at the same time. So we'll just wait for the thing to switch, if it's going to switch. It may not. There we go, there's a track switch, and we'll just wait for the next song to start. pull the tape out. Now we're going to make sure that it passes a signal to the radio when there's no tape inserted. And I'm just going to feed a tone into the wires that would normally go to the radio speaker wires, and just make sure that this sends the signals where it's supposed to go. Now you won't be able to see it on my meters, so there's no point even having the meters up. Oops, get rid of those. Alrighty, we're looking, okay, the blue wire says to right radio output, so a tone fed through this should come through the right speaker. Okay, there's that tone. Now we're looking for the left radio output wire. Should get a tone through the left speaker. And there's that tone. And I'm just going to check the voltage real quick. That you won't be able to see because I don't have a camera trained on my voltmeter. But I'm just going to make sure that it sends 12 volts to the radio when there's no tape inserted. Looking at the power to radio wire, that's going to be right here. Power to radio, test it, and we got 15.2 volts. And that's the voltage I use for testing. So, everything's cool on the 8-track. She's ready to go back to the customer. I'm ready to get on to the next job or maybe take a little break. Just depends. You just never know what I'm going to do here. Let's go ahead and dismantle this puppy. Get her all ready to go. Okay, and she's ready to go back. And I'm ready to get on out of here. If I can find my face, there's my face. I'm Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. I'm sure you know the spiel, so I won't say it again. My number is 928-533-9666. My website's in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, listening, and we'll see you next time.